Hey guys, this is Feisworld from Feisworld Media. This is an unusual video because I'm showing you how I make my at-home DIY hand sanitizer. The reason is, doesn't matter where you go these days, we're talking about mid-March here in the United States. A lot of these grocery stores and drugstores have them sold out. So you can't even find them anywhere, including Amazon. Of course, it's much better to get them pre-made. However, if they're not accessible to you, I'm recording this video, following all the rules and guidelines by CDC to using all the appropriate ingredients to make at-home hand sanitizer. So let's get started. Let's get started and learn how to actually make your own hand sanitizer from ingredients and products you can get right from your local grocery store. And if you're lucky, some of these ingredients are also available on Amazon as well, and they are quite affordable. However, regular hand sanitizers are out. CDC highly recommends that you use alcohol that's at least 91%. So if you only have 70%, that's not sufficient. However, if that's all you have, it's better than not having it at all. But I would recommend 91%. In some places, you can find 99%. That's super pure. Actually scares me a little bit. But the ingredients you need in order to make your own at-home hand sanitizer are just a few things. You need aloe gel. There are many versions of this type of products everywhere. There's a clear kind. There's one that's of like a light green color. So there are also green versions of, this is like not even out of the pack yet, but as you can see, it's green aloe gel. So there are definitely options. The one I have from Wegmans is clear. I have 91% alcohol. And then also importantly, you need an empty jar to actually store the large or medium amount of homemade hand sanitizer that you want to keep in a bottle like this. This is much smaller compared to this, but depending on the size of your family, how long you want to keep these things. One thing I would say is when you have an empty bottle, make sure you clean them first. Another thing you might want to do and need is get a ruler or, you know, like a kind of a measure tape of some sort and just a marker, permanent or erasable. The reason is that what we're going to do in a second is to measure the height and of this bottle and decide the volume or the amount of aloe you're going to pour in at the same time with the alcohol. Now, according to CDC, what you want to do is to have two-thirds alcohol and one-third aloe. I know there are different websites saying that you should have half-half or at least 60%, right? At least 60% of alcohol, that's 91% impurity, and the other one-third of aloe. Now, I studied math. You don't need to be a math major. Let me give you an example. I'm going to include some calculation in the description below as well. For example, this is a really large and tall bottle, and it's about 7 inches, as you can see, 7 inches in height. Now, all I have to do is do some math, which is two-thirds, which is 2/3 times 7. That's it. That's what you need, right? If it's 6 inches, it's 2/3 times 6. Anyway, what it came down to for me was basically 4.66 inches. It doesn't have to be exact, but what I just did is I used this marker to lightly mark the height of the alcohol I'm going to pour in first so that you can eyeball it. I don't think it needs to be exact. So let's get started with the operation. Okay, that's about right. So next is we want to pour in aloe into this. So again, looks like this is going to take a while. So I'm just going to take off this thing here and see if I can just squeeze in all the aloe I need. All right, looks like we are pretty much done. It's a little messy. I just found a clean chopstick. I'm going to kind of stir it up the bottom. And it's a good idea now to make the bottle super full. As you can see, I leave some surface here. So when you shake it up, there's room for the two liquids to blend. So as I'm doing this, I'm going to kind of it gets a little messy, I do like a towel to kind of wipe things off a little bit. So I'm pretty happy with the results, because once the texture is good, you will see that you can see some of the aloe kind of free floating in there, but for the most part, it's kind of mixed in with the alcohol. Now, the final part, as I mentioned, is that you can bring in certain scents of your choice. Some people use peppermint, tea tree oil, or lavender is another popular one. So all you have to do is open it up and just mix that in. So in terms of the scents that you can consider, I will include some links below. So here's one of the first ones. This is peppermint. This is a pretty big bottle, easy to use, but more popular ones that you may see in the market, including geranium. This one is quite nice. But also this is grapefruit. So you can get pretty creative with what you want to mix in there. So many, many choices to choose from. Definitely don't want to go too crazy either. So let me show you a smaller bottle I made from earlier this morning. So as you can see, the aloe is pretty well mixed in there. I can see kind of little bubbles inside the bottle. And before I kind of use it on my hand or put in a smaller bottle, I just tend to shake it up like this. Now, it is not, like I said, they tend to separate pretty easily. I'm not sure if you can see through the video, but the aloe tends to fall at the bottom, whereas the alcohol continues to flow at the top. So before you use it, you want to make sure that you just shake it up once again. Mix it before you kind of pour into little bottles. Speaking of little bottles, some of the ones I would recommend is, you know, the ones that you didn't throw away from your previous purchases, a Purell, these bottles are great. Just reuse them. Make sure you wash them beforehand. And then because, again, you tend to keep these things in your purses, right? And they can be a little bit messy. Now, these are the small travel size bottles you can get from any dollar store, Target, Walmart, or simply on Amazon. So, yeah. So these are my creation of at-home hand sanitizer. Last but not least, if you're making these at-home DIY hand sanitizer, like I said earlier, aloe does tend to separate from alcohol, so I try to leave a message or a label on top to say this is homemade and make sure to shake before use. I've written it in Chinese as well because my mom is staying with us, so make sure you shake before you use. When you see these fine bubbles throughout the bottle, you know it's ready to go. Otherwise, the aloe is at the bottom and you're not getting any alcohol when you kind of pump this out. That's it. Hope you find this helpful. Peace.